Welcome back, guys, to Dishonored, and you may notice something weird that I'm back inside Dunwall Tower proper, looking for that last ruin, because there was no way to scale the outside of the place. Couldn't find a single way to do it, couldn't see a single way. It doesn't look the right thing to do, which means that, of course, because the region, whatever he retreated to before, is connected to this main building, that whatever we're looking for to get to that last ruin, somewhere around here. So I've done a little bit of infiltration already. I'm just looking around for something. Any kind of clue to where we need to go? Of course, there have been some guards or some places where we've completely negated taking out the guards, like here, for example. It's painting up there, in fact, so here we go. Now, which way will you travel, sir? Past the door, but the other guard's coming. Let's make sure no one sneaks up around us. That would be very bad. But you're coming back, so we're going to grab you. Take you away. And mind you, take you away where is the next question. You're in this big open room, sir. There's nowhere we can... Oh, didn't mean to make that much noise, that's for sure. Close this door, that guy's hiding in the corner there. Someone's always supposed to be on duty somewhere. Considering the fact that we're in an area where we haven't picked up any more collectibles for a while, safe to say that this might be where we're heading. Where collectibles lie. It's good stuff. Like trays. And of course, paintings. We need the paintings. This is of the Empress and the Empty Set. We'll take that indeed. Right, any place to put these guys in a nice safe manner? Or one of you can step... Oh, didn't work. We'll say one of you can stay up there, but that's not working at all. I would put you on the table there, but I'm not sure if someone can see you if they walk past. Say problematic. Put you on the small table, I guess. Or I could find somewhere to put you over here. There's a table. Come with us, friends. Trying to keep you safe from the rats here. No one kept walking around. I don't know what on earth happened to that overseer with the magic box. He's kind of disappeared a bit now. Right, we managed to put you up just about. Wonder if we can get you on there as well. Man, we move so fast with sprint now, and so silent is the best bit. Oh, you kind of nearly made it on. We need to get a bit further across, I see. Yeah, that'll do. The rats will have to jump up to get you, but stairs upstairs to an extra floor. That's exactly what we were looking for. There's still no marker of anything good. Door to take us to a new area, I hope? Good. Tower rooftop. Couldn't find a way at all to climb the outside of the castle, so this was the only option left. So I came back in for, we'll have a look around. Gotta make sure we pick up all the collectibles that we can. At least the ones that make up our mission screen, as it were. Now there must be some guards up here. Rats. Guards behind us, I guess. Or above us? No. Multiple rats. People talking. Aha, here we go. That's a bit too many rats. I hope they don't want to be eaty. Stop squeaking. Ooh, I can make it in between the pillars. That's good. Oh, the guy with one alert thing didn't see me in the end. Okay, someone's coming past to look for me. Mm. That was the only way I could see a way to escape that situation there. Ho! There's another guard over there as well. This is problematic. Nice place to store you without rats getting you. Up there is where it's going to have to be, I'm afraid. Well, this place doesn't seem to be the most heavily guarded one. Oh, he says to jinx himself. Right, there's the rune that I'm after all along, though. With you up there, nice and safe, well, he says. Gotta make it past this tall boy, it seems. Oh, failed that. In fact, I can't make it up there at all. Really? Okay, we can't climb up there. So we have to head through the main entrance? I doubt that very much. Now, is this door open or not? That's the next question. Okay, good it isn't. That means I can hijack you. Take you to a nice place where no one can see you scream. Not that I'm actually intending to make you scream, however. Would you like to go to sleep up here, sir? Safe from rats. Yes, it's even safer if you squeeze between there, sir. It's a good idea. It seems the roots I have are mostly here. Now, getting past the tall boy, however, that's going to be a bit of a tricky one. Probably not with stop time, but still. It saw me, but it's not going to be able to chase me out here, is it? Sir, can you have stayed looking that way? Oh no, an overseer now. Well, there's no more music box. We can still use our powers, that's good. However, getting up and in looks like only that side is our option. Keep you safe from the rats, even though we hate you very much. Have a nice rest. Okay, where are you now, tall boy? Okay, this is gonna hurt. Okay, we need to disable that wall of light, but how we do it, there's another question. Supposedly, we can walk through these things if we use stop time, so it looks like our only option to do anything here is to do exactly that. Should we go for it? My god, how did you not see us? Seems like nothing can tell me the way that I need to go, as it were. Alright, I'm gonna hide underneath in the meantime. Seems the ruins upstairs where the wall of light is, most likely. We must be able to find a way to this box somewhere. Aha! Great. Heading to the back was the right option at that moment in time. However, Sir can see us, which is not a good thing. But he may be able to see us, but he's not got any way to reach us as we keep going around. It's a bit weird that's... Oh, it is an arc pylon. I really should pay more attention to what's going on. Right, with that taken out, we have a way through. Keep seeing me, sir, and it's getting very, very annoying. Well, I don't really care for the collectibles that much anymore, so stop time it is. As soon as he turns around, we're gone. We're out of there. We're going, we're running. And the ruin is right here. 4 out of 4 ruins found. New powers can be obtained, but is it ones we want? We can indeed get vitality too. We have 3 ruins, cost 2. Let's get ourselves a little bit of extra HP. Or can we not? Oh no, we need 1 more ruin. Ah! Well, that sucks. Either way, we got in. Now it's time to get out. We should be able to do this with a nice little bit of dashing. Try to see me if you like, sir, but we're long gone. Now, is there a way down in a simpler fashion? A way to jump, a way to climb? Or will doing so eliminate my life? If you know what I mean, I'd prefer not to have to climb all the way down again. I mean, well, climb all the way up again. I hope this works. Downwards seems fine, great. So we know that we've cleared out the left-hand side, so it's time to head back to Samuel. Mission complete. Everything picked up. Let's keep heading around on the right-hand side and we should be completely and utterly safe. He says, jinxing himself. Ow! March around all you like. Guess I can't make it. Oh, I can make it back all the way up there. Lush! Of course, it looks like we can simply fall all the way back down. No guards. Samuel, are you out here? Are you waiting for us? I hope so, that's for sure. Samuel, take us away from this place at last.
Is it all done? You ready to go back to the Hound Pits?
Yes, I am. Let's get out of here.
Thanks to you, Corvo. All right, let's go.
Freedom at last! Right, we kept the chaos low even though we did kill a couple of people. 2 in fact. Dead or unconscious bodies found 4, so we weren't as good with that. We killed the Lord Regent's torturer and exposed the Lord Regent's corruption publicly. We also got not so much of the money, but every item again, so that's great! Or at least every recorded item, you never know what you might miss around the place. We haven't seen a blueprint in a while, so maybe we missed one of them, I don't know. All the same, stealth boots are the main one we need for our playstyle. So Coronation Eve, the Lord Regent has been defeated and the reign of Emily Caldwin is now assured. All that remains is to see her safely escorted to Dunwall Tower where she will assume her position on the throne.
Big changes. Makes me uneasy to tell the truth. A small fry like me always gets the worst of it. But maybe it's going to be different now. The Lord Regent is gone. The Abbey has a new High Overseer. I'm guessing our work is almost done. The others are in the bar. No doubt waiting to raise a glass in your name. Me, I think I'll just linger out here if you don't mind. Reflect on things while we have a moment. Congratulations, Corvo.
Long live the Empress, you say? Celebration time is here! Anything hidden around the place? The location? No, it doesn't look like it. Is everyone in the bar waiting? Well, apart from whatever that is, the river crust, that's what it is. Seems like everything's dealt with, and Emily's waiting for us to come through the front door. Nice to know, announcer guy. Long live the Empress!
I'm taking part in history here. Dunwall is on the verge of a new age, a better age. And this old sailor has had a role to play in it. I doubt I'll be remembered, as the worthy men who made this happen are truly the heroes. And one feisty little girl who hides the sadness of missing her mother very well, bless her. But perhaps someday someone will listen to this and know that a humble sailor named Samuel was a part of it all.
I remember you, Samuel. All Samuels are good after all. That's not my catchphrase for this. It sucks that this is your bed.
I know it's a good day, but the rats are still here, aren't they? I look out at the river and still see the bodies going by.
I'd have just thought you'd be treated better than this. Should talk to Emily some more. At least you've got me on your side, eh? Anyway, let's put away the weaponry and say hello to a little girl.
Corvo, everyone says you did something good tonight.
I'm only killing two people as well, I'll have you know.
Definitely he's done it. Word is spreading all over the city. The tyranny is over. By this time tomorrow, Emily will be on the throne. After that, we'll clear your name and put everything we've got into rebuilding the city.
I wish there were more of a city to rule. Most of Dunwall is rats and corpses.
The Admiral was right, I'm afraid. Corvo, you did your job while the rest of us sat on our asses. Our work starts tomorrow.
Tonight, rest easy. Tomorrow, we crown an empress. To Corvo, the man who served to change the course of history.
To Emily Cole. And the new dawn rising for Dunwall and the Empire.
That's good to know.
Entire mathematics, court protocol, and cosmology.
Gotta get the beds in order.
You provide these things?
Of course.
Lots of talking going on.
I just think I should have a central role. She trusts me.
It's true, she does, but she should trust all of us. Don't you trust me, Callista?
Okay. Well, what's going on here? Whoa, what? I'm either really drunk, or something's going on here.
I must have a portrait made. Maybe Sokolov will do it, after what we've been through here.
Campbell's black book lets me control.
What's up, Lady Emily?
We're leaving tomorrow, aren't we? I don't know if I want to go back. I can be imprisoned from anywhere, right? Maybe a ship.
Something is not right here. What have they made me drink?
Emily comes first. In a pinch, Wallace could manage the estate.
What on earth have they made me drink? Rest before escorting Emily to her coronation in the morning? I'm not sure I want to. They've made me drink something.
Do you know Emily is quite special? She learned from all of us, you especially. She trusts you absolutely, I believe.
Oh no, something bad has happened here. Well, the only way to find out what happens next is by going upstairs and actually finding out. This is not good. That is not a normal sound for a drunk. Something is not right. The whole place is warping in my eyes. That's not a drunk warp, especially considering the noise that goes with it. And everything has changed to a darker tone.
Samuel, you move like you've been drinking. Did the poison work its magic? Is he dead?
It better have worked. It cost me a month's profit.
Yes, sir. I believe Corvo has breathed his last. Just as you wanted.
You've done a fine job, then.
Remember, we need the body. If we come forward with the corpse of the man who murdered the Empress, we'll be greeted as heroes.
Yes, it'll grant us legitimacy. We'll be the men who rescued Emily and brought down the Lord Regent and his assassin. You'll see to the body, won't you, Samuel?
Yes, sir. I'm sorry something terrible, Corvo. But I only gave you half the poison. They were watching me, and it was all I could think to do. I think you're strong enough to survive that. I'll put you on a raft, and then I've got to ship out myself before they find out I've gone against their wishes. Snakes. They'll want to do the same to me as soon as I've outlived my uses. Hopefully you'll wake up and find your way out of this cursed city.
I was about to say et tu, Samuel, but actually, it seems that all Samuels are good in the end, despite the fact that he has to go along with him because of the position he's in. At the bottom of the food chain, we're adrift, betrayed by Havelock, Martin and Pendleton. You were only saved at the last moment by Samuel the boatman, who left you adrift in a ruined section of Dunwall. This sucks.
This is the one who was with the Empress when she died. Poisoned. Tivian stuff.
Amateur work. He'll live.
That's up to Daud.
Things just continue to get worse, don't they? I'll live is not as good if I don't be picked up by a bunch of assassins that try to kill me at the start, and that's superly bad to just leave me adrift like this.
I know a great deal, bodyguard. I recognize those marks on your hand. A gift from your friend. The one who talks to you in the dark. Talks to you when you visit his shrines. I visited those shrines too. And I know what it felt like to shovel blade into your Empress. But I don't know you. Who you are, and who you fight for. You're a mystery. And I can't allow that.
Well, seems I've been knocked clear unconscious, but ended up cooled by the outsider, and all my gear is gone as well, so that completely sucks for a start. Right, things keep going from bad to worse, but maybe the outsider has a way to deal with this.
Here you are at last, in a ruined and drowning world, held captive by the man who killed your Empress, the assassin Daud. Your friends poisoned you and dumped your body in the river. Did they do it to protect themselves, so no one would ever know what they'd done? Or was it because they were a single move away from controlling an empire, and they knew you'd never let them manipulate Emily? Maybe none of these. Perhaps that's just the nature of man.
Well, that was not exactly the most helpful thing ever, Mr. Outsider. How on earth am I going to get myself out of this pickle? Not that we need our weapons, we haven't even been using them, but still. At least we have our powers, and our trusty arm that is used to strangle everyone. I would have liked my sleep darts, though. Nice to see you. At least let me keep my mask. And rats in a little tunnel here. Escape, you say? Well, I could just, you know, smack that out, maybe. It's not exactly the most intelligent prison I've ever come across. That's for sure. We even have a bone charm in the area nearby. Well, actually, not that near, really. Well, I wonder if we can get out this way. Hi, rat. Drop down. Surely they'd know about the powers that I can have, if you know what I mean. Surely they'd have this information, but obviously not. Oh, they let me escape that really fast. Return to the Grease Refinery where your gear was dropped. I need that. I need the gear. Ow, ow, ow. What's eating me? Are those fish in here again? What on earth hurt me there? Or better use a potion. Keep myself... Ah! Right, so that's all the HP I have. All the health I have. And all the magic I have as well. Maybe I should have looked for a more physical method of breaking out. No guards nearby, it seems. Dead bodies, however, and rats. Potions. Beautiful food and potions. And Corvo's bounty note. Daud, finding Corvo in possession of that mask could have been an elaborate frame job. But now the newly minted Lord Regent Havelock, oh god, is announcing to all the city that he has a proof linking Corvo to the mass felon. The bounty is 30,000 coins, but if Corvo truly is the mass felon and is responsible for all the things the wanted posters accuse him of, I expect the bounty to double. Because we have him alive, we should be able to barter for even more. Well, why did he meet with rats then? Regarding Slackjaw, we watched him for a week, and when we were ready to make our move, he suddenly disappeared. Maybe he left the city. Where's Slackjaw gone? Anyway, I'll pick up a nice little shiv here. A little something-something, at least. Report to Daud. This is the musical device that the Overseer had strapped to his chest. While it was functioning, we were unable to perform transversals or tetherings. I suggest we all get a good look at it. Can I nick it? That'd be a good idea. Well, I want this blade. If we nick that thing, we could stop them entirely and fight them hand to hand, as it were. Man. These guys really don't like me. Well, why is there a dead guy down here? Oh, an Overseer. No wonder you're dead. You must have came with the music device, so to say. But anyway, we should be able to get higher up than this, I'm sure. There should be another way out. I don't think it's in there. Unless it is, maybe. We see the rats underneath. That's our prison. But we escaped from. They're not even noticing the fact that I've escaped. Stairs further upwards. Okay, good. You're not going to come up? Well, guys. We found ourselves in a pickle. Poisoned and set adrift, then, well, trapped by the assassins of Daud. We now make our escape, try to find our weaponry, all our equipment, and survive this situation. So join me for that next episode, guys, as we play more Dishonored. Thank you. Bye-bye.